A really good jobs report, restaurants struggling to find employees, the Suez Canal creating some interesting problems with the auto industry, and vaccine passports. Hey guys, welcome back to the DemCAD channel. I'm Reginald, also known as DemCAD. First, the auto industry is being affected by the Suez Canal incident where a shipping container, had a bunch of shipping containers, massive ship, created a backlog. The ships couldn't get through. One of the consequences is that a lot of the chips are coming out of Asia. A lot of the microchips, a lot of the computer chips are coming out of Asia that are used for various parts. Weren't able to really get to Europe. As a consequence of that, now the auto industry in the U.S. is looking at, they're scrambling to find ways of coming up with these computer chips because it, like, the whole incident went on for a week. So that's a week in which those chips weren't able to get to Europe. So because a lot of cars are made with a lot of computer chips, a lot of components, they're obviously being affected at the manufacturing level. So this is one of the consequences of globalization, having a global economy. Yes, you do get access. You get access to new markets, cheaper labor. But you know, the simplest thing, like one ship in a canal, could create some serious shortages in your company. An incident in a lab in China could create some serious consequences for industries all across the world, including the restaurant industry right here in the U.S. Now, this isn't just an article I read. I've heard people talk about this incident, this whole phenomenon of people not willing to work because they don't have much of a sense of the work in the restaurant industry. There's a lot of reasons behind that. But nationally, there's a report that there's articles that restaurants are struggling to attract employees again. And I can understand why a lot of people will be hesitant to return to the restaurants because a lot of people lost their jobs when COVID-19 hit. And a lot of people didn't get a lot of help. So why would you want to return to an industry where you felt like you were mistreated? I completely understand that. And then you have the phenomenon of the stimulus checks. Now, a lot of people are talking about this. A lot of people are saying, hey, if they can get these unemployment checks, these federal unemployment checks, these enhanced unemployment checks all the way to September, there's really no incentive to rush back to work this summer in the restaurant industry. This is something that a restaurant owner was talking about in the video on the article on the link below. And I completely understand that too. You can take the whole summer off. like you said, you know, you either choose to take the whole summer off and you know what type of check you're going to get, or you can work in some job where you never know. What if COVID-19 comes back again? You know, it's so much uncertainty. It's a risk. And he also mentioned a lot of people are moving on to other fields, such as construction. Well, I can definitely see why people want to do that because there's probably more stability there as long as there's a housing market. But each industry comes with its risk. Now, speaking of construction and industries, the non-farm payroll numbers came out as far as jobs. And the expectation was there was going to be 675,000 jobs created or so. It was actually 916,000 jobs created in the last month. Or so. I mean, that's what came out in the March reports. Well, so those are pretty good numbers. I mean, unless they're completely bogus or so, if those numbers are true, those are good numbers. Most of the gains are coming in the hospitality industry and leisure. So we're seeing that open up again. There's also 110,000 jobs added to construction. So that's a little bit news right there. So yeah, those are some things. Those are some good things that are going on right now. Some things I don't like, COVID vaccine, the whole concept behind it, the whole concept that you have to produce evidence that you took this vaccine in order to gain access to certain areas. Be able to leave one country to go to another, I kind of get. Countries can do whatever they want, but I don't think it should be restricted within our own country. And I definitely don't think you should be restricted from accessing certain businesses based off of a COVID vaccine passport. I mean, here's the deal. You're basically saying that you're going to deny people access to areas and resources based on their decision not to take a unproven vaccine, a vaccine that hasn't been tested long term. I mean, that's just a fact. Whether you like the idea of a vaccine, whether you take it or not, or whatever, we don't know the long term effects of this vaccine. We know the long term effects of similar vaccines, but not quite this vaccine. Okay, and there's a release of liability. If you take the vaccine and something bad happens, if you're injured or something, or you can't really necessarily, you can't just sue Pfizer or Moderna or whatever, whatever the company may be, Johnson & Johnson, whatever, you just can't sue them. That liability has been removed. That's how they were able to get it onto the market so quickly. So I understand why people wouldn't want to take the vaccine. I don't think it's fair to try to punish people, lock people out of certain parts of society because of it. Now, speaking of which, European airlines, they love the idea of a vaccine passport. Okay, they want this, but they don't want to pay for the whole system of verifying that the person took the vaccine. I mean, they want the governments to pay for it. Now, the EU's talking about, they have a plan, but the airliners, they don't really want to pay for this. Florida Governor DeSantis issued an executive order banning companies in Florida from requiring their customers and patrons to have a COVID vaccine passport. What this means is that if they violate it, they could risk losing grants from the state of Florida, and they could also risk losing contracts involving the state of Florida. Russia, Ukraine. Russia is warning NATO not to send additional forces into Ukraine. This comes on the eve of footage indicating what appears to be Russian forces building up in an area close to Ukraine near the border, of course. Russia's saying that if NATO sends more forces in there, it'll be viewed as escalation. I'm definitely keeping an eye on this right here. All right, so question of the day. Do you think these stimulus checks, do you think this elevated unemployment checks, do you think they're providing an incentive for people not to go back into the restaurant industry? Do you think there is providing an incentive for people not to work in general, or maybe it's just the restaurant industry? What are your experiences? What are your thoughts? Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.